The largest land animal ever known was Argentinosaurus. One bone of this giant was as large as a grown-up human. The complete skeleton hasn't been discovered yet. Still, the scientists claim this dinosaur could be around 121 to 131 feet. If seven Argentinosauruses stood in a row, they could replace the London Bridge. Pterosaurs were usually large. The smallest species had a 10-inch wingspan, while the largest ones could have it up to 36 feet wide. For comparison, the largest span of a modern bird's wings is just about 11 feet. They were the size of a modern giraffe, but they weighed less to be able to fly, only 550 pounds. Brachiosaurus was 86 feet long, and it had an incredibly long neck, standing over 40 feet in the air. Its whole body was designed for this animal to get food from trees easily. Its hind legs were relatively short, and the front ones somewhat longer. Diplodocus had curious teeth shaped like a comb. The dino was 85 feet long and weighed slightly more than three elephants. Its neck was so long that scientists aren't sure how the animal could even hold it. Parallotitan was about 82 to 100 feet long. Its bones were so large that Parallotitan could even rival Argentinosaurus in size. If they invaded London, four of these creatures standing on each other's shoulders would be enough to fix Big Ben's hands if they were a little too fast. Austroposeidon, what a beautiful name, huh? Is the largest among all the titanosaur species. A fully grown animal was about 80 feet long, which is around one and a half of a Hollywood sign. Spinosaurus lived where the Sahara Desert is now. There used to be rivers full of fish and lots of swamps, so it lived both in and out of the water. It was almost 50 feet long and had a large plate on its back that looked more like a sail and spines on its sides. Tylosaurus was one of the biggest creatures that ever lived on our planet. It grew to 45 feet long, ate fish and even larger creatures like sharks, except for the Meg, which was about the same length. Tylos had a really weird extra set of teeth on the roof of its mouth for a better grip and grind. Despite its large size, T-Rex was really fast and had a large brain. This terrifying 40-foot-long dino was related to a chicken. It came from a bird family and might have had feathers, so it's technically a very angry bird with very sharp teeth. Their tiny arms with two fingers were the size of human arms. Suchomimus looked like a retro version of a crocodile. By the way, its name actually means crocodile mimic. They were about 34 to 36 feet long, almost twice as long as today's longest saltwater croc named Lo Long. It measured slightly above 20 feet. Parasaurolophus had incredible jaws that would grind and not chew plants. It had a weird head ornament. The scientists still aren't sure about its purpose, but one of the most popular theories claims it was much needed for regulating temperature. These giants were 12 feet tall and over 30 feet long. Allosaurus had 8-inch long claws, 70 massive razor-sharp teeth, and a flexible skull. Thanks to its bone structure and jaws that could bend outwards, these dinos could grab and hold even the largest chunks of meat. They were only 9 feet tall, slightly taller than the world's tallest man, but very long, having 32-foot bodies. Stegosaurus was famous for the plates that adorned its spine. They were used as thermocontrol, soaking up sunlight during the day and distributing it all over its body at night. They had a pretty small brain compared to their body mass. These dinos were about 30 feet long and 13 feet tall. A triceratops weighed 8 tons despite a plant-based diet. They were quite slow walking because of that multi-ton weight. To chew those leaves better and faster, it was geared with about 800 teeth. This many teeth would never fit in a human's mouth. It's as if one human had teeth of 25 adult individuals. Compared to his dino mates, Majungasaurus was relatively short, around 6 feet, yet quite long, about 25 feet. Its enormous tail would make up over 50% of its body length. If these guys lived in London, there'd be no way they could take a double-decker, being just the same length as this famous London bus. Plateosaurus, which literally means a flat lizard, was about 23 feet long. It weighed like 4 cows and had large claws for thumbs that it could use to collect food. Scientists aren't sure if it walked on 2 or 4 feet. Gallimimus was about 20 feet long, thanks to its large tail. It was also pretty tall, about 9 feet. A human being could stand without bending under that tail if it was raining. It wasn't that broad, but enough to keep one human dry. Dilophosaurus was quite into eating fish. Its teeth weren't powerful enough, and the front ones even had a gap between them, so real hunting was sort of a challenge for it. These dinos were about 19 feet long, just about the size of a giraffe stretched on a grassy lawn, and 6 feet tall. Pachycephalosaurus, let's call it simply Paco, may not have been the largest of its kind, but it had spectacular 3D eyes. If you invited it to the movies, it would probably need no glasses on. It would be hard to find a comfortable seat for your new buddy, though. It was about 16 feet long and 5 feet tall. Dracorex means the king of dragons, probably because of the numerous knobs on its head that looked like a crown. It had tiny front arms, so even if it had a crown on, it wouldn't have been able to take it off. They were about 15 feet long, had awesome sharp teeth and incredibly hard skulls that were a perfect soft cushion for their tiny brains. Troodon was shorter than an adult human, only 4 feet tall, but it was wider, measuring about 6 feet. Scientists believe it was the smartest dino of all. Compared to modern land animals, a Troodon was as smart as an ostrich, and these guys are brainy. It also had a lot of teeth, letting them eat different types of food. There was one dino as large as a human being. An average human is about 5 foot 6 inches tall and 1 foot 6 inches wide. This guy was slightly larger than a human lying on a couch, 1 foot 6 inches tall and 6 foot 5 inches wide, thanks to its lovely tail. It's a velociraptor, a bird-like dinosaur. Even though these birds had wings and feathers, they were unable to fly. Another dino that could blend in human groups, if they coexisted, was Borogovia. It was neither tall nor wide, both measurements under 5 feet. It could be a nice prehistoric pet. Microraptor wasn't that good at flying, despite having long feathers and long upper arm bones. It could probably glide from tree to tree, looking for some food, or even launch itself into the air and fly short distances. It weighed under 1 pound and was about 2.5 feet long. Giraventor was only 2.5 feet long, shorter than a Maine Coon. Many theropods were bird-like, but this dino most likely had scales instead of feathers. Anchiornis was another giant chicken, just like T-Rex. This guy had colorful feathers and was impressively good at flying short distances. Still, long distances were quite challenging for it. They were tiny, only about 13 inches long, and weighed no more than 4 ounces. The smallest dino that had ever lived on our planet was Oculodentibus. It was even smaller than today's world's smallest bird, the bee hummingbird. But while the latter prefer eating some freshly picked nectar, Oculodentibus had razor-sharp teeth and preferred insects to sweet flowers. It's kinda unfair to talk about prehistoric animals and not include Mr. Mammoth. They weren't that large, just about the size of a modern African elephant. The main difference between mammoths and elephants is the ear size. Because of cold climate, mammoths had small ears and kept them close to their heads. Their tusks were 15 feet long, about the length of a Dragorex.